I know it's early in the morning. And I know I'm running a bit of a risk here. Because I do have a protection order against me. From an ex. But I feel everybody deserves to know the real truth. The very real truth. About how all this began. And how I got in this position that I'm in. The world deserves to know the real truth. And you guys cannot sit there and say that I'm breaking or breaching the protection order against me, because I'm not. I'm merely speaking the truth about a situation. And the person that I'm not allowed to, whose name I'm not allowed to speak, I'm going to say it anyway because they are part of it. They are the reason why it started. Back in 2017, before all this started, I met someone by the name of Candle Smith. Didn't know who she was. You know, I met her through a mutual friend of ours. And we began dating. Little did I know that that would lead to the worst nightmare of my life. One day we were sitting down talking on FaceTime like we always did every morning. And she had told me to remind her the next day, you know, told me to remind her to take her meds the next day. And I thought, okay, cool, I can do that. So the next day rolls around and I remind her to take her meds. The next word she said is what caused me to leave her. She sat right there and told me that she could not take her meds because she was part werewolf. And that the meds would affect her. She even showed me a picture of her dog's paw. At that time, to make it look like it was real. And after that, I broke it off with her because for me, I knew she was lying and I wasn't going to stand for her lies. And I didn't know it until next day, but about an hour after I had cut her off and blocked her, she had proceeded to go onto Facebook and onto YouTube and say that I supposedly raped her and that I supposedly was a pedophile. Spread it all over Facebook, all over YouTube, everywhere. So I contacted her several times to tell her to knock it off. To stop the lies. But they didn't. They kept going and going and going for years. And then one day I was on a live stream with a friend. Who unfortunately now no longer speaks to me. We were doing a podcast that we ran at the time called the Chill with the Boys podcast, where we had different artists that we knew, different people that we looked up to, you know, and friends of ours as well. And Ian had to work that day and he asked me if I could take over the podcast. And I told him yeah, because I had ran the podcast a million times before, so I knew what I was doing. And then in comes this guy named Music Biz Marty into the chat during the podcast. And, you know, at first I took him as a hater. So I did what one of my personal favorite artists did at the time, which is Ryan Upchurch. And I cracked jokes at this guy, thinking that he was, you know, just another hater. Little did I know that that wasn't actually the real Music Biz Marty. When I later found out who he actually was, I tried to apologize to him and let him know that somebody was pretending to be him. Later on, I found out that that was all a setup. And I later found out that the person that was in his chat, or that was in the chat during the podcast, I found out that it was actually him. And Marty began doing little things to, you know, to bully and attack me. And at first I ignored it. At first I did ignore it. Or I tried to. I tried my best to ignore it. But it eventually got to the point to where, you know, I couldn't. And I said something to him. And for a time he did back off. For a short time. And then a few months go by, and I find that Candle drug me into this group chat on Facebook, and I didn't know what it was about, but I found that Heather and Candle were arguing over something, and I didn't know what was going on. And Candle tried to make Heather seem like just this awful, awful person. And I knew something was off, so I pulled Heather aside and I talked to her. And I asked her what was going on. And she had told me what was really going on. And after that, we ended up talking more and more every day, until eventually we ended up together. We ended up dating. And Heather already knew at the time that, you know, when we started dating, she already knew that, you know, that I did music, that I was a YouTuber and stuff like that. And she was okay with it. And there was one day where we had met Jamie Nicole through a good friend of mine, Courtney Knight, who I'm still very good friends with to this day. Shout out to Courtney. Fucking love you, girly. You're fucking awesome. But we were all hanging out on a live stream. It was me, Heather, Jamie, and Courtney. We were all hanging out when I found that Marty made a pass at me. And I initially did not catch it. And Heather was the one that caught the video. She was the one that caught what he said. And she had me go back. Like, she had me leave the stream and go back and watch it. And I did. And I kindly turned Marty down. I told him, no, I'm not interested. Little did I know that those few words would lead to much worse things. There's a screenshot that I do still have on my phone, where he basically told his now ex, Violet, who I'm still good friends with, that I was his and only his, and he did not care. Essentially, he didn't care what laws he had to break, that I was going to be his. He basically said that I'm his property, I belong to him. And that if he couldn't make money off me, then why should I be allowed to make money? Why should anybody else be allowed to make money off of me? And I still have that screenshot saved to this day. And I confronted him on it. I told him to back off. Little did I know that would lead him and Kendall teaming up. She sent him the video where she called me a pedophile, and he ended up taking that idea and utilizing it. And his plan was to isolate me from all my friends. That was his plan, to isolate me from all my friends, so that I'll have no choice but to run to him. And how did he do it, you ask? He did it by hiring Mass Troll Mafia, aka Kate Peters. He hired her to do the worst thing that no one should ever do to anyone, which is illegally entrap someone. And regardless of what the screenshot said, because I know damn well she edited that shit to make herself look good, but during that incident, she pretended to be 18. Tricked me into sending a photo of myself. And then she had sent one back and then claimed to be underage. Regardless of what the screenshot says, that's how it actually went down. Because I know a lot of you guys are all like, oh, that's a lie, that's a lie. The screen, you can't edit screenshots. Yes, you can. Especially if you know someone like Michael J. Hacking, who's good at Photoshop. Because if you're good enough at Photoshop, you can Photoshop anything. But after that incident went down, she then behind the scenes proceeded to Photoshop the screenshots to make it look like I actually was a pedophile. And ever since then, I've been called every name in every fucking book under the sun. My family's been attacked multiple times. I ended up going to jail overnight as a result of it. I ended up losing my job at the time that I had with a very good friend. Because of the allegations of me being a supposed pedophile, I ended up getting kicked off the label that I was on. And then I ended up working with my friend Enoch, who runs his own gaming development company. and as a result of the allegations, I ended up losing that job. I ended up getting fired. Which killed me because it was my first real job that I've had in a long time. Ever since everything went down, I've lost friends. I've had a family member disown me. My own dad disowned me. And just yesterday I found out that one of my closest friends had just passed away because someone laced his weed with fentanyl. And then the day before that, I found out that another good friend of mine that's in the military, Owen, I found out that he's laid up in the hospital right now, and they don't know if he's going to make it or not. You know what gets me? The one thing I've never understood is how someone so evil could exist in this world. Like I said, I understand that I'm running a risk, but you know, it's the truth. And to be honest, that's why Candle got the protection order against me to stop so that I wouldn't speak the truth, so that I couldn't. So that she could try to shut me up from speaking the truth. And I understand that I'm running a risk. But it's the truth. And I know a lot of people don't believe me. I know I've got a lot of people that hate my guts. Because of the stuff that went down with Kate. And I understand that. I get it. But let me ask you this. Who's the real evil person? Who's the person that's really at fault? Is it the one that they chose to victimize? Or is it the one that does the victimizing? Because I did my research on Kate Shirley after everything went down. I did my research. And I found out that Kate is actually a drug addict. And she has lost two of her kids to Children's Services because of her drug habit. All those people that she has on her channel, all her subscribers, to her, they're not people. To her, they're money to fuel her drug habit. And I also later found out that she's an attention seeker and will do anything for a view. Whether that means illegally entrapping someone, or just flat out making them look like shit. Now, I personally have had a few conversations with some of her victims, such as Turtle Boy, who actually is one of the nicest people I've ever met in my life. He truly is one of the nicest people ever. And it was through Turtle Blade that I got my hands on the article that spoke out stating the things that Kate has done, such as filing a fraudulent case document, threatening people that she was in court with. And just doing all kinds of things that are just, you just don't do. But as a result, because of Kate and Marty and all these people, like I said, I've lost a lot of friendships. I've lost a lot of friends. Like I said, I understand that me falling for that troll was wrong. I get that. But that doesn't mean I deserve to rot in jail for it. And if anybody should rot in jail, it's Kate. She's the one that should rot in jail. She's the one that needs to be behind bars, not me. And that bullshit excuse of saying that you illegally entrapped me, Kate, because you said that I gave off pedophile vibes, that's not an excuse. That's not a reason to do what you did. You had no reason. And I'm telling you all right now, for those that are watching this over on YouTube, you guys can go back and watch my, watch all my videos from before I started getting bullied, and you can see how it affected me. You guys can go back and look at my arrest record. I was only put in jail one time for an incident between me and my moms, which I ended up getting counseling for, and I had not done anything like that since. But outside of that one incident, I've never been arrested for anything in my life. I've never broken any laws. I've never done anything wrong. And for those of you that sit there and say constantly that, you know, that you want me to do better, you want me to be better, you want to be a better person, okay. If you want me to, let me ask you this. If you want me to be better, then why won't any of you leave me alone long enough to do better? I can't just change like that overnight. That's not how humans work. That's not how people operate. That's not how people work. You don't just change overnight. It doesn't work like that. It does not work like that. In order for someone to change, it takes time. And as for William Gloryhole, you need to shut the fuck up, dude. You sit there and say that I don't deserve to make a living off of what I love. Who are you to say what I can and can't do with my life? Like I said, I know I made a mistake and I owned up to it. I owned that shit many, many times. But it's like my honest apologies that I actually meant, don't mean anything. But like I said, who's the real fucking bad guy here? Is it me, the person that got trolled and illegally entrapped? Or is it Kate fucking Peters, who is a drug-addicted attention whore, who will do anything for a view, no matter how extreme it is. I think the answer is pretty fucking clear. And you know what's really, really bad about this whole thing in general? Yesterday, I was on Kick, and I was performing a live cover show to honor my good friend Brendan, along with some of our other friends that knew him through Facebook as well. We were all there, we were all gathered there, and I was doing a cover show of all his favorite songs that he liked, that he introduced me to, and that I introduced him to. Because that's what he would have wanted. He would have wanted it like that. And so I did the honorable thing and did a cover show. In the middle of that cover show, one of the trolls went in and reported my account for supposed hate speech when there was no hate speech going on. And this isn't the first time they've done this. This is not the first time they've done something like this. They first started going after all my channels and my ways of making money back in 2019. Back in 2019, I had just hit 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. And I had just put in the application to get monetization for my videos. What did the trolls do? They went in and mass reported me and got me shut down for no reason. Back in 2021, my friend at the time, Christopher Friend, aka Nihilate, knew that I had a YouTube channel, or a Twitch channel, and he decided that he wanted to help me. So what did he do? He went in and he boosted my stuff. You know, he boosted my stuff. He went in and helped me get to boost my follower count. He had helped me to boost my follower count. And I was doing good. You know, I was doing really good for myself. I had went from a mere 15 followers to over 860 something followers within a matter of a couple days. And out of those 860 some odd followers, 20 of them were actually paid subscribers. Like, I had just gotten affiliate. I had just hit an affiliate from Twitch. I was halfway to partnership. And I was making good money for myself starting out. I was making about $111 a month. Doing really well for myself. But then what happened? The trolls came in and they mass reported me for something I did not do. So they're saying that I was doing things outside of Twitch that I was not doing. And it was after this incident that I would later figure out that these trolls do not want me making any money. Every time they see an opportunity to keep me from making money, they will do it. There's been a couple people on my kick that have came in that are trolls where they have said, oh, this is a daily reminder. Do not donate to this pedophile, because if you do donate to him, you are then going to be targeted as well. That's what these people do. And what's even worse is in the middle of all this, Marty decided it would be funny to pretend to be different females that were interested in me, just so he could solicit nude photos and videos from me, which he would then pass around the internet. He would then post those videos to porn sites, share all the photos around Discord servers. All to extort me. In the mix of all this. And the only reason why my family has not been able to fight back is because we don't have the resources here in Akron, Ohio. Here in Akron, Ohio, we don't have a cyber crimes division. We don't have the resources to fight. But thanks to a very good friend of mine over in the UK, I now have a way to fight. But this is the living nightmare that has been my life since late 2017, early 2018. Like I said, I understand that I'm running a risk, but you know what? It's a risk I'm willing to take if it means clearing my name. If it means getting my life back to normal, I will take any risk that I need to take. There is no risk too big or too small. And trust me when I say I would do that for any of my friends as well at the drop of a hat. Any of my friends, any of my family, I would do it for them at the drop of a hat. And I know that if Brendan were still here, he would want me here doing what I'm doing right now, standing up for myself. So now you guys know the real truth. Kate Peters illegally entrapped me. And Marty is an internet terrorist that likes to go around and extort people for views. These people are actual criminals. These people are actual internet terrorists. And they will terrorize anybody if they can get away with it. I've seen it quite a few times. And all those times of me freaking out that I know a lot of people have seen, all those times that I've raged out, those were for a reason. Those were because I got tired of being bullied. I got sick and tired of all the lies. I got sick and tired of being pushed around. I got sick and tired of people like Marty trying to extort me. Not to mention all the blackmailing that they've done to me and my family. Saying that if I didn't do this, then this was gonna happen. That's blackmail. And it's even worse now because CBG, the YouTuber that goes by the name of CBG, he now has a group on Facebook called Chance Wilkins is a Child Predator and is in your friends list. They've amassed over 2.8 thousand people in that group, solely dedicated to attacking me. And one of those people in that group is my now former, by my former adoptive dad, Gordon Wilkins. Which, by the way, I will be getting my last name changed. Because after all this shit, I have no respect for him and I want nothing to do with him. Oh, and Gordon, you don't have to worry about paying for my name change. I don't want your money. Because God only knows what drug lord or drug dealer you got that money from. So I don't want it. You can keep your blood money. You can keep your drug money. I don't want it. I don't know who you've killed. I don't know who you get your drugs from. I don't know. But I do know that I want no part of it. So you can keep your dirty money. Well, like I said, this has been my life since 2017. Not able to live my life. Family always being attacked. Family being stolen from. Me being illegally entrapped by Kate Peters, who's one of the most hated people on the internet. And if you don't believe me that Kate Peters is one of the most hated people on the internet, look it up. She actually is one of the most hated. And it's not for anything good. It's for all bad shit that she's done. It's all fucked up. And you know, ever since 2017, I've been trying to get out of all this. I've been trying to do good for myself. But again, I ask this. How am I supposed to do good for myself and better myself if no one lets me fucking do what I need to do to make money so I can focus on my job as a content creator and as a streamer? That is my job. Okay? That is what I was making money at before I was attacked. I deserve to have my job back. I don't deserve to have my stuff shut down. I deserve to be able to make a living doing what I love. And again, like I said, I apologize for that stuff that went down with Kate. I apologize for that. But yeah, you guys don't want to let me move on, do you? You don't want to let me move on and live my life. Even though she was the one that started it. You know, it's funny. Everybody always wants to attack the victim in this situation being me. But yet, no one wants to go in and go against Kate and question her actions. Because she has so many subscribers. Fuck the subscribers, dude. Start questioning shit. Why do you think I question everything? Because of shit like this. Always question everything. No matter how small it is. If it's something that you think even might be just the slightest bit off, question that shit. Why do you think I always question everything? And like I said, it's very funny that no one wants to confront Kate and no one wants to, you know, interrogate her or take shots at her. But yet everybody wants to take shots at me because of my mistake. But yet she's the one that did the mistake in the beginning. She's the one that illegally entrapped me. She's the one that's at fault, not me. I'm basically apologizing for being victimized, and I shouldn't have to do that. So, like I said, and I said this the other day, you trolls think that you're going to shut me down, but you're not. Because like I said, I'm not going to jail. I know all about the fake people that you guys are trying to make look like I went after. I know about the people that you're trying to set up to come forward as supposed victims when they're not actually victims. They're actually trolls of yours. So no, I'm not going to jail, I'm not getting killed, and I sure as fuck ain't going to no goddamn group home. Your plans are done. It's over. You guys need to grow up and move on. And like I said many times before, all of you need to grow the fuck up. Get the fuck off of the goddamn internet. And actually go out and get real jobs. And it's funny because you guys tell me to get a real job. But yet, what do you do every time one of my friends or me gets a real job? You go in and you call until we all get fired. You did it with my biological father. You did it with my friend Brendan, who's, you know, unfortunately now passed. And I know damn well, if I got a regular job, you'd call up there till I got fired as well. When does this shit stop? Because it needs to. This needs to stop. Every last bit of it. Oh, and calling somebody a lolcow is not okay. Because when you call somebody a lolcow, you're basically stating that all they're good for living for and their only purpose in living is to make people laugh. If you want somebody to make you laugh, go to a comedy show, man. Go out, go to a comedy club. Watch YouTube videos of comedians. You know, watch people like Jeff Dunham, Brad Williams. Watch Fluffy, aka Gabriel Iglesias. There's plenty of people out there to do that. Don't be going around victimizing people like that. Because like I said, my rage outs were not funny. They were me at my lowest point when I was screaming out for someone to help me. For all of this to fucking stop. All those rage outs were me begging and pleading for everyone to fucking leave me the hell alone and to stop going after me. But yeah, y'all don't care, do ya? Y'all don't give a fuck. You guys just want your little bit of views. You don't care. You don't care about the law. You don't care what's right or wrong. You don't care what's legal or illegal. All you guys care about is one thing. Money. And how do you get that money? Views. And where do you get your views? Victimizing people. Extorting people. Blackmailing people. People like you don't deserve to be on the fucking internet. You really don't. And if anything, every one of you needs to be locked up. And trust me when I say, with what I've got going on right now, by the time it's done, you guys will be locked up. You guys will be in jail. For many, many years. And I'm not joking. I am starting to take legal action against every single person that has victimized me. Starting with putting a stop to all the videos being made about me. That's the first thing I'm putting a stop to. And how am I going to stop that, you might ask? Trust me when I say, I have my ways. And that's all you need to know is I have my ways. But on a side note though, for everybody that has had my back throughout all this, man, all my friends, all my loved ones, I want to say thank you guys. For every person that has ever reached out to me, asked if I'm okay, checked on me to see how I'm doing, tried to steer me and push me in the right direction, I want to say thank you to all of you. You guys are truly amazing, and I love you all just so much. And I appreciate every single one of you. And to the people that do genuinely enjoy my music and my content, I can promise you that I will be reaching out to every single one of you privately and sending you where I will be posting content from now on. But that being said, I love all you fans, all my friends, all the supporters, I love you guys. And I thank y'all so much for being there for me. But as for everybody else that doesn't know, that didn't know the real truth, now you know the real truth. Now you really and truly know what's gone on and what's been going on. Now you know how all this got started and how it led up to all of this. I thank you guys for listening. With that being said, I gotta get my day started and get ready. I wanted to come on here and make this video and, you know, really speak the truth. The real truth. That isn't being manipulated by the internet. But the honest to God and real truth that no one wants to speak out about. Well, that being said, I love you guys.